Today's song is How Beautiful by Twila Paris. It's her most popular song on Spotify. She says that the song is about how we, as Christians, in our service for God, should reflect Christ's example, who showed us best how to serve. Bible verses are directly and indirectly referenced throughout the entire song. The first two verses of the song speak of Christ and the beauty of his sacrifice.
How beautiful the hands that served, the wine and the bread, and the sons of the earth.
This is referring to the Passover supper Christ had with his disciples, where the Lord's Supper was instituted. In that upper room, the Lord Jesus bent down and washed the feet of his disciples, the lowly role reserved for a servant. Christ's humility was on full display in both his life and his death, which is what the second verse speaks of.
How beautiful the heart that bled, that took all my sin and bore it instead.
Christ laid down his life to redeem mankind from our sins. Without his saving work, we are helpless. Our sins demanded punishment, and Christ took that punishment on himself. This is why every Christian can agree with the refrain.
How beautiful is the body of Christ.
The interlude is a transitional stanza where the song takes a turn from speaking of Christ's physical body and focuses on the church, which the Bible describes as the body of Christ. But we'll talk more about that later. The song goes,
and as he laid down his life, we offer this sacrifice.
I think this line is referring to Romans 12, where we're told to be living sacrifices, patterning our lives after Christ's sacrificial death. The song goes on, as Christ paid such a great price to redeem us, what a great debt of love we owe. So we live lives of gratitude and lives of service in direct reflection of the unspeakable service that Christ did for us. The last two verses talk more in detail about the church. We live lives of patience, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ. The church is also understood to be the bride of Christ, and we wait with desire for the day when we will see him and enjoy the marriage supper of the Lamb. In addition to waiting for his coming, the song goes on to talk about what we as Christians can do to imitate Christ's example. Christ said that there is no greater love than to give one's life for their friends. As he did it, so do we, living each day with a desire to share the message of life with those who are dead in sins, as we once were, and to see them saved by grace through faith in Christ Jesus. This is what the last verse talks about. This line is a direct reference to Scripture. The good news mentioned in the song is the gospel, which is what the word gospel means. So we are God's messengers, his ambassadors to the world, preaching the gospel to every creature. We are also to help each other, our fellow believers, as the song says. As Christ loved and served his disciples in that upper room, we are to do the same, edifying and building each other up, so that we can work together to accomplish his will. The song ends with the same line that was sung before. But now it's speaking of us, the body of Christ, and how when we serve like Christ served, God is truly pleased with us and sees our service as beautiful, holy, and acceptable. In a very real way, we are His body, His feet carrying the good news to the ends of the world, His voice proclaiming the truth of His word, and His hands lifting up the downtrodden and the hurting. There isn't anything doctrinally questionable in the song. However, to those ignorant of the fact that Christians are collectively referred to as the body of Christ in Scripture, the song may not be completely understood on first listen. Let's take a look at the uniqueness score. Using the formula to process the song's word repetition data, the uniqueness score comes out to 41%, which is an average score. It would have been higher except for the repeated lines in each stanza. So, Twila Paris's How Beautiful, a song about how the service of the church reflects the sacrifice of Christ. Are they just lyrics? Decide for yourself. And let me know in the comments.